Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm excited to be making a new video, bringing you a little life update and the things I'm looking forward to in 2024. So, sorry it's taken a while to make a video. I feel like I say that all the time, but I truly mean it. First of all, I hope everyone had a very Merry Christmas and that you're enjoying your new year so far. And so let's talk about that. Let's talk about the new year. What's happening? What's gonna go on? So I'm gonna start by talking about this channel a little bit. What I want it to be, what you guys want it to be. As you know, you can always leave comments. I read them all. I'm always looking forward to improve and bring you things that would be valuable to you, that you enjoy, and that are practical in your life. Not just something that's like, oh yeah, that was a nice little pep talk. Like, I like a pep talk. I like things that make me happy, but I also like things that are practical. So I'm hoping that I'm always doing that in my videos. So one thing about this channel, you know, people on YouTube talk a lot about like content creation and being YouTubers, and you gotta find your niche, and then once you do that, you gotta niche down so it's an even smaller niche. And I'm not saying that's bad advice. I'm not saying it's wrong, and I'm not saying I haven't tried to do that myself. It can be a little bit ambiguous like when you start out, but I think I've always had a through line which will continue to be present, and that is like, so I'm an artist, right? I have no problem telling that to people. I create hopefully beautiful things that people enjoy. But if I were to niche down, I'm a filmmaker, right? But that's still fairly broad, so I can niche down even more and say, well, I'm an actor, which is true. I generally say filmmaker though, because yes, I am an actor, but I'm also a screenwriter and I'm a director. And depending on the time of year, depending on what I'm doing with my life, I can be in this lane mostly this part of the year, and then in this lane. So I try not to spread myself too thin, but I love every aspect of filmmaking. So I'm a filmmaker, but who knows, maybe this year I'll be more of an actor. I'm not quite sure yet. So with that, I hope you have enjoyed the videos that I've already made. I plan to still make similar content. I plan to adjust if I need to, if you're not enjoying what I'm making, or if you like this more than the other. So like, obviously I do movie reviews and I do book reviews. I think that's still right now for sure gonna be part of the channel. Long term, years and years from now, I really don't know. And I'm not even saying that I don't want it to be, but whatever the case, I'm always gonna be talking about movies and I'm always gonna be talking about books and art. So like, that aspect is never gonna leave. That's a big theme of this channel, is it's about being an artist. It's about being a creative. It's about storytelling. Storytelling is a huge thing, because storytelling is present in basically every form of art. Like even in a painting, you can like, draw out story in it. And as I've said before, you are a character in your life. Like you are living a story, and then you're also a character in the grand story, right? Like God's story. So we have value in that, and we have purpose in that, and you can find story in almost anything. It's pretty remarkable. So I'm hoping again to dive into that more, dissect that more in a way again that will be practical to your life. So since we're talking about that stuff, and I know this is a quick life update, so I can't dissect these things too much right now, but a couple things I've really enjoyed in 2023 in terms of films. I think my favorite film of last year was Godzilla Minus One. If you guys have not seen it, you've got to check it out. I don't care if you're a monster movie person, Godzilla person, what, it doesn't matter. It's phenomenal. It's a Japanese movie, and it's really cool. It's set right after World War II. The human element of this movie is amazing. Any monster movie, you're always expecting people to die. I mean, it's just kind of what happens in monster movies. And you also just normally don't grow too attached to the main characters, because usually there's a good chance that they might die. But every character was so interesting, and I was concerned. Like the whole time I was like, no, like I don't want Godzilla to stomp on this person. You know, like it was really, really good. I really enjoyed that movie. I haven't done too many book reviews lately. Sorry about that. I have been reading, just not as much as I'd like to, but I can talk about what I'm currently reading, which is Merlin, written by Stephen R. Lawhead. It's the second book in the Pendragon cycle, which is it's a series of Arthurian legends. It's really cool so far. There's a new streaming series that's being made right now, and I'm trying to finish the second book because I think the first season encompasses the first two books, but really, really liking it, so highly recommend so far. There's your quick like movie book talk for you in this little update. That being said, I'm going to try and be more consistent this year. I can't make any strict promises right now. I don't have a schedule of like, oh yeah, every single Monday. Now I'm working on like a private schedule for me, so like I said, that I can be consistent, but I don't want to let anybody down by being like, this is the schedule. So I would say keep an eye out and look for more videos. And when I get to a place where I can really do that and be like, hey, this is the schedule that I'm hoping to have for you guys. I would love to tell you that, but I don't want to let you down right now either. Please, 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 if you do enjoy these videos, let me know. And if you do want to see it more consistently, please let me know. I need encouragement. I always need that little like boost of like that what I'm doing matters and that it matters to you guys. If we're having a good time, let me know we're having a good time and I'll really, really keep pressing forward in all of that for you. Another thing that I'm really excited about, and hopefully you will be too, is the idea of starting a podcast. Now, this is what this looks like right now. Because again, I can't commit to a ton of just crazy projects right now. I'm focusing on these videos and YouTube and things for you. So this has to fit into that right now. So if you don't know this about me, aside from just talking to a camera, I love conversations. I love talking to people. I like a good deep conversation. I like a fun and frivolous conversation. I like all kinds of conversation with hopefully the intention that, again, that it's full of joy, that it's full of things that are valuable. Even if they're silly conversations, I think there can still be value in that. But I'd like intentionality in my conversations. And I wanna learn from people. And I have really great friends. A lot of them are very creative and really cool and smart. And when I talk to them, I'm always like, why don't we have a podcast, you know? And so again, I can't force these people to consistently do that with me either. So what I'm gonna try to do is work with people's schedules and have cool conversations. And, you know, again, they're probably gonna be around storytelling, but it might be like, okay, yeah, we're talking about movies, but we're talking about the hopeful messages in movies. So that's a video. And then I have people who are musicians. There's storytelling aspects of music. How do you compose? Like, do the lyrics just kind of pop into your head? Like, you know, just their process. Things like that. So I wanna really bring valuable things to you. I'm hoping too that this provides an opportunity to meet more people. I love meeting people. I love learning about their lives. And again, if they've got the ability to help me grow as a person, that's incredible. But since we have all this technology now, since I've got this channel, I've got this place where you can come and you know, digest some of that, hopefully I can bring you things that you would not get otherwise. I love that idea. And if you like that idea, please let me know. And I'll really try and work really hard at that. So everything that I do, guys, if you haven't got already, I hope is something that is life-giving, that is encouraging, that gives you practicality in your life. So if you're excited about the idea of those types of videos and a future like actual podcast, please let me know. All right, guys, this next one I'm really excited about. I've been working at this for like around 2 years now, and it's getting so close. I have a poetry book coming out. Pretty crazy. Like, as you know, I'm a storyteller. I've written things, but I've never written anything like this. The name of the book is called Spirit Well. It's a small collection of poetry, so really digestible, not too long. You know, it's not like 12 pages or anything, but it's not very long, so easy to read. And I'm really hoping that you guys enjoy it. I've done my best to be honest, to pull things from here that really, really matter and that you can connect with. I've tried to take things that I find are valuable, that I think are valuable to other people, that again will bolster you and encourage you in your life and point you in a positive direction. I've tried to write these things out and say these things in truth and in love. And that is a huge thing about this as well. Honestly, it's part of the reason why I started this YouTube channel is I had a lot of things a few years ago that I really wanted to say and I just didn't feel like I was able to say it. And I felt like I was almost imprisoned in these thoughts and these words, and it's like, I need to articulate this, I need to get it out. I really hope it's something that will bless your life. There were things I wanted to say that, you know, might be difficult to process or hard-hitting, and I wouldn't strictly say offensive, but maybe. And the intention is to not offend, ever. I don't like offending people, but I'm also uncompromising in the truth, guys, especially in this world that we live in now. Like, there's no reason to walk in lies or falsehood or anything like that, because all that crumbles, all that falls away. There's no foundation there. So I've tried to present this in an artistic way, in a hopefully a beautiful way. I tried to write it as beautifully as I could and engaging as I could. I've tried to present important themes, important topics in a way that is entertaining, that is fun to read, and at least gets you to think, at least starts a conversation and at least builds bridges, right? So hopefully you can go about your life and you can look at people with new eyes, that you can see them for the valuable person that they are. So I'm really hoping that this is something that actually helps you look at other people with more compassion and more love. That's really the intention behind this. So look out for the book. It's coming soon. I can't give you the date just yet for various reasons, but very, very soon. So if you aren't already, please follow me on all my different social channels. I'm basically everywhere. I'm on, you know, Instagram and Facebook and Twitter and Threads and all that stuff here, obviously. And that kind of segues into the next update, is that I'm starting an email list. So be on the lookout for that. So I'm kind of revamping my website a little bit to where you'll be able to hit that subscriber link and stay up to date on everything that I'm doing. So I want it to be a cool newsletter. I'm gonna have hopefully different, you know, categories of things that you guys can participate in. So if you subscribe to the list, like, you'll know when the book's being released, and I'm hoping to give you guys some freebies. Now, they may not be super extravagant just yet. I'm working with what I got. So, you know, I'll give you poems that are gonna be in the book that you can read leading up to, and digital downloads, things to that. Like, again, I don't have it locked in yet, but I wanna be able to give you value for signing up and down the road, you know, so like early access to certain things, or, you know, discounts on certain things in terms of, like, if I write more books or if I make more movies. I want it to always be a place of value for you. I don't want it to be a place where I spam you by any means. So again, give me tips, give me ideas, what you like, what you don't like about things like that, but I hope you will subscribe when that is ready. Also with that, I plan to be writing more in general. I do hope to write more blog type things, more newsletter type things. With whatever I'm gonna be writing and releasing to you, I'm gonna do my best to encapsulate in those things how you can apply that to your everyday life. I'm trying to give you things as a creative that you can apply to your life creatively. Be on the lookout for more articles, blogs, writing, posts, things like that. Also with the website comes hopefully new products. I'm working on a store for my page, and in that store will be this shirt that I'm wearing. I designed this shirt. Part of that was I just wanted to wear something that I thought would be cool and that has meaning to me. And this says Heart Ablaze on it, which is the name of a poem that will be in the book. The poem is written on the back of the shirt. I'm not gonna show you just yet, because again, updates, things are being released. It's all coming. Obviously, this is the white shirt. I've got a black version of it too with the white lettering. So those will be on the website as well. I'm really looking forward to this, guys. I feel like this is a new step for me as an artist, as a creator, a way that you can support me if you want to support me. I'm really trying to really step into this role now that I've been doing for a long time, honestly, and I don't know if it's out of hesitation, fear, I don't know what it is, because the desire has always been to give people value and give them things that they enjoy and like. And I think I've done that. And I think there's trepidation at first when I was younger, because I was like, oh, I don't know if people are gonna like what I make. They may think it's awful, and I'll be crushed, and I'll feel bad that I asked them to pay for things. I think I'm beyond that now. So I'm not trying to say Steven Spielberg or, you know, whoever, but I've been doing this for over 20 years now, and I've got some experience, and I've worked professionally and independently, and I've worked in live performance, and I have a film degree. So again, I'm not trying to be like, oh, I'm so great, look at me. But I just say that I've been doing it for a while, and I think it's time. I think it's time for me to just be like, hey, I'm a filmmaker, I'm an artist, I'd love for you to follow along this journey. And guys, again, not to sound all high and mighty, but I just haven't been too impressed with what's been happening in the world lately in terms of art and in terms of movies. And I think a lot of it has been just filled with, like, propaganda and activism. And I know that art has and always will be an outlet to say important things that people believe in, that they care about. But I think too, art is supposed to show the beauty of this world that we live in, the beauty of creation, point to God and all the good things that he's given us, and to be entertaining and to be fun. And yeah, it runs the range of emotions, that's fine. But at the end of the day, art is something that we use to kind of escape the drudgery and the difficult things that we all have to go through. But art is a great way to be reminded of, like, there's more to life than the drudgery. So when art becomes the part of the drudgery and the frustration and the like, you need to do better, and like, you're not a good person because you don't think the way, like, that's when we have a problem. Here's leading into kind of my last point here, is I really hope to make more actual films this year and to act more. I really don't know what that looks like. I don't have an agent at the moment. I did years ago. The world that we live in today, the way we can connect with people and DM people, I think there's so much opportunity again, and I think the landscape is shifting in terms of streaming and new companies coming up. There's a lot of shakeup in the entertainment industry right now, and I think there's a chance and the potential for a lot of independent creators and studios to rise up, and it's actually really exciting to me. So if you're a director, if you're a writer, actor, whatever, and you'd like to work together, like, that would be fantastic. Hit me up in the comments, DMs, whatever. And if you want to check out my films, if you haven't seen my films, I pretty much always link them in the description of my videos. It'll be in this one. So check them out if you want to see what I've already done. My acting reels on my channel as well. But I'm super excited about that. Guys, I think, as I've said before, art is so important to the culture. It's so important to how we live in this world and how we treat other people even. If you're creative or want to be creative, follow along this journey with me. I encourage you to join in the process. Maybe you just like watching things. Maybe you support artists. We need people like that, right? I've noticed even with my dollar, like what I've been doing lately, with where I've been paying for my movie ticket or whatever, like I'm much more selective now. And I think that's okay, but man, there was a time when I was just seeing movies like several times a week and all this stuff. And I'd like to get back to that, if I'm being honest. So if you've got things you're working on, let me know. Like, I want to support other artists. I want good art that that helps make this world a better place. Art has such a big part to play in that. And I think it's time for a renaissance. I think it's time for a revolution. I think that the bigger studios, bigger companies, they've dropped the ball. And whether they're willing to admit that or not, I think it's extremely evident in the numbers of people, again, where they're spending their money and movie theater attendance and all these other things. There's so many factors right now that point to the fact that this is such a unique time. There's such a unique opportunity to really step into this and be a part of something big. So let's do it together. Let's support each other. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. It means so much to me. If you enjoyed it, please feel free to share it with somebody who you think might enjoy it as well. You can always, you know, like, subscribe, whatever you want to do. But I really appreciate your time, and thank you for watching the video. I look forward to the new year, and I'll see you next time.